Hi, I'm Gerardo from AWS.
Hi, I'm Jinjin from DBS. This is my architecture.
Today we're going to talk about DBS Bank's quantitative pricing engine. What can you tell me about this application?
DBS is one of the largest banks in Asia. We are providing a variety of financial services to our customers, including trading companies. Quantitative pricing engine is one of the systems that we built in-house on top of AWS services for processing highly dynamic workload.
Okay, let's dive in. So how do the traders interact with the application?
The traders will initially trigger the pricing from DBS internal trading platform, taking the external data to the application load balancer. The application load balancer will forward traffic into pricing engine. Pricing engine will store the accurate payload into Redis and get the job ID stored in a task queue.
I'm guessing a subset of that market data gets into the payload. And then are these queues being pulled by the workers?
The trade information as well as market data will store in the payload. Mm-hmm. The worker will monitor the task queue. The CPU worker, once found the task queue has some item, will pop one and put into the processing queue. Mm-hmm. And then the pricing worker will retrieve that payload from Redis and get that payload, go through a mathematical computation, and produce the result and store back the result into Redis.
I can see you have two different types of pricing workers. Why is that?
Some of the job itself have a high computation power intensity. Mm-hmm. So we are actually leveraging the GPU instances to do acceleration in case CPU is not able to process in time. So similarly, the GPU worker will monitor the task queue for dedicated GPU task queue and pop one into the GPU processing queue and retrieve the payload from the Redis and similarly do the computation and save the result back into Redis.
How spiky are these workloads? Are they on auto-scaling groups?
Yes, they are on auto-scaling group. The pricing engine, the worker for two CPU and GPU cluster, they are on a different auto-scaling group. Mm-hmm. And sometimes they can even scale up to 5,000 workers.
That's a lot of workers.
Yes, they are.
How do you optimize cost of that?
One way is actually by auto-scale them down in case there's no much job per se. On top of that, we're also leveraging the spot instance to reduce cost.
All right, and what happens next? So after the results being stored in the payload, how does that get back to the traders?
Yeah, that's a very good question. We have two mechanisms to get the result back into traders. Mm-hmm. One is the pricing engine will do periodic pooling from Redis to see whether the result is available. On the second approach, we actually trigger a result available from the worker and publish in the PubSub channel. Then the PubSub channel will get notified to the pricing engine, and the pricing engine will return that result back to the traders.
Could you tell me why you're using ElastiCache for Redis for all of this functionality?
Yeah, the Redis was picked, the fundamental reason, because it's a performance in terms of saving as well as retrieving the data. Mm. On top of that, it's providing the PubSub feature, which is add-on, and we just leverage that to improve the performance as well.
And why using PubSub for this final step instead of just pulling a queue?
So pulling a queue may have a certain lag because even talk about 100 milliseconds or tens of milliseconds, that's still a gap. So instead of doing that, the worker can just publish saying, hey, my result is available. Mm-hmm. Then the pricing engine will pick up from there.
Right. So I can see how all of these architectures being optimized for speed. And yes, I'm presuming those pricing requests from traders are quite time sensitive sometimes?
Yes, they are. The trader are actually expecting the pricing for ad hoc pricing to be near real time. So they are on the spot with the pricing, expecting to come back to them immediately. So previously we have this in the on-prem cluster. The pricing is actually ranging in 2 minutes. Now with this new architecture, we actually reduce timing to nearly half a second. So it's almost like 100 times improvement in terms of performance.
It's a massive performance boost.
Yes, it is.
Jinjin, thank you so much for sharing this architecture with us today.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching. This is My Architecture. See you next time.
Thank you.